Hey everybody, how's it going? Why does this shit keep happening? After 16 years in prison, a fucking DNA test clears a convict of sex crimes. Over a decade and a half later, are you fucking kidding me? Okay, two scenarios come to mind where that happens. One, extremely incompetent investigators and such, and oh my fucking God. And the people in the labs were clearly fucking morons in scenario one. Scenario two. They didn't even fucking bother to test him before he was sent to prison for 16 fucking years. Either way, both of these scenarios are unacceptable. Because when a person's future hangs in the balance, you have to make sure the evidence is 100% on the dot correct. No less. Because you know what happens when you don't make sure? This kind of shit fucking happens. It's disgusting. The people and the examiners in charge of fucking fly. Oh. Still not as annoying as this fucking shitty justice system and the incompetent bastards that let this happen. You can bet your ass that this definitely isn't the first guy this year to be let out of prison after something proved that he wasn't the convict or the perpetrator. Let's go into detail, shall we? But before we go into details, if you go to the link, which I will put below, you will see an excerpt from an interview with the man's daughter. She says, and I quote, "My father meant the world to me. I made poor decisions because I didn't have a father to guide me." So, incompetent fucking lab techs, people giddy to get a conviction. Both of those, one of those two, or those two and something else, leads to the changing of his, of this man's daughter's life. You see, it doesn't just affect the accused, It affects them. It affects those around them. That's something the courts and the fucking prosecutors and the people involved in actually testing the DNA and the evidence, they don't fucking think about that, obviously, in this case. So they don't work as hard as they should, and it should happen, and we arrive at this moment here. Oh, and believe me, this is far from the first kind of fucking shit like this to happen in the last few years. It seems I don't go even a week or two without digging in to the interwebs and reading, bam, another man falsely convicted, just released after X amount of years. See it all the fucking time. All the time. And it's sickening. But let's go into details. A judge on Monday overturned the conviction of a man who spent 16 years for sexual assaults that DNA evidence later proved he didn't commit. Shitty lab techs. The judge at this point in time said the evidence completely and unerringly pointed to his innocence. Why not just get a fucking DNA, two DNA tests from the guy to make sure there is no room for error before he's sent away to prison? Holy fucking shit. Oh, and here's the kicker. His lawyers believe a notorious rapist on the FBI's most wanted list was the responsible party. There's only one thing I can say to this. Eyewitness testimony is about as reliable as listening to that of a blind man's. You know why? The so-called eyewitness could have seen no more than a shadow. No more than literally a glimpse. Or a partial look at a quarter of his face. When your only evidence is fucking eyewitness testimony or identification, chances are you probably shouldn't be able to convict them. You should have to wait until you can get a clear and decisive DNA test. Oh, and of course, down in the article, this was a shaky eyewitness identification case. They all are, because they're fucking unreliable, because they're eyewitnesses. Oh my god. This happens all the time. The number one factor in wrongful convictions across the country is mistaken eyewitness identification. You don't say. Well, and I'm sure behind that, the runner-up is false claims of sexual assault. But this whole fucking time, it was the man known as the teardrop rapist. Guy who's attacked 35 women. He was sentenced to 55 years to life in prison. For a rape and two attempted rapes, which now is pinned on the teardrop rapist. Go figure. In the 16 years he served, he only got to see his granddaughter once. And get this, it was at a community college graduation ceremony held inside the prison. Nice. I get the restriction on, I got the restrictions there, but for fuck's sake. 16 years. Wait, hold the fuck up. As soon as you get the technology to examine this shit, shouldn't all cases like this be retested or tested? Because I'm pretty sure examination of DNA didn't become recently available in, like, fucking, I don't know, last year? So, at this point, he could have been free in, I don't know, 04, 05? Yeah. The lawyer for the Innocence Project credit the DA's office for standing with him in court to say the conviction was a mistake. Okay. No shit, it was a mistake. This happens all the time. The number one factor in wrongful convictions across the country is mistaken eyewitness identification. So, the number one cause of wrongful convictions across the United States is because somebody's not sure what they fucking saw. Are you kidding me? That shit, as we see here, leads to a man going to prison for 16 years and his daughter growing up fatherless. They say eyewitness testimony is unreliable. Well, no shit. Absolutely sickening. Absolutely sickening. Fortunately, this man is now, for all intents and purposes, free. Going back down to the bottom of the article here, Vargas has been sending books to his granddaughter in anticipation that he'll finally be able to read them to her. That's awesome. I'm glad he's basically free. This shit should have never fucking happened in the first place. We all know that. The judge knows that. The fucking jury knows that. Can we just fucking get it ruled? So unless the eyewitness testimony of a person can be proved 100% accurate down to every last detail, that unless that is the case, it is inadmissible in court. Can we please fucking get that? Because unless we get that kind of shit or something like it implemented, this shit will continue to happen. And more people will go to jail even though they didn't fucking do shit to deserve it. God damn it.